computer system, your entire personality. I'm not saying this to fat shame anyone, but sometimes it really can get ridiculous. Here are some examples. You have Namekians live by the Free Software Foundation, like it's the word of God, with an altar of Richard Stallman hanging on the wall. For dinner, they ate feet fungi, as Stallman preached. And as for the choice of woman, yeah, you get the joke. There are probably like thousands of these kinds of people who keep following other people's ideologies about software. You know those things that run on your computer? Like Disney Mechan, who was an actual capable programmer. He refused him to work anything but a minimum wage grocery store job because he does not want to contribute to the proprietary society. Or this one, who posted himself a multiple angled picture of himself naked on Wikimedia. They are just walking car crashes, and there are so many of these kinds of people. Then you have those thinking they are some hyper advanced elite soldier or hacker for installing Gentoo on an encrypted variety store SD card and running it as their only OS because the clothes will get to them. Instead of running Temple as like a real hacker man. Or those who keep talking about how rising the desktop will 10x their productivity while they have written zero lines of code on the hyper personalized NeoVim setup. To those who behave like this, I have to say, pause Mr. Robot, calm your air and go outside. You don't have to do anything outside. Maybe you can go back inside. You can get a gym membership, read books which aren't about computers, you know? Kidding a little more. I understand that it is a hobby mindset, but if you reach the point of you serving the hobby, then there isn't really a hobby. It's more like an addiction at that point. Like, I've been there. I've tried every Linux distro or whatever under the sun. I made writing code in C and using that to earn personality trait. I was in the cult. Like, I would go on 4chan G, and that's where my opinions came from. My ideology just was based on 4chan's technology board. But then I realized something. There's nothing wrong with not bothering. Your time is being wasted spending it on only on something which doesn't create anything. After that eye-opener, I changed the way I use my computer. I just used what worked. Here's my setup. I have a laptop, an old one. I will go to this funny story, but it runs two OS, Haiku and Linux Mint. You think that I'm being a hypocrite, and I am. But using an obscure OS and the Linux OS instead of having a MacBook with a Magic Touch maybe isn't really that strange. However, here's the thing. Haiku fits my desire for a computer, not for a woman, because I'm not married to it. I use Haiku to browse the internet and it loads really fast. And it looks pleasing without going through a zillion config files. Linux Mint is there to do anything Haiku can't. If Haiku can't do something, I just go and use Linux Mint. I'm not married to an OS. Of course, if Haiku can do something, I like to develop on it. That's my hobby. I'm not dependent on it. On my desktop, I run two OSs, FreeBSD and Windows 10. I use FreeBSD for being an actual productive since all dev tools are there. If I need something that FreeBSD can't, I just use Windows 10 and do it there. This has been this way for a year by now, and I have chased config file forever and ran enough of this nerd talk. My point is that those who attach too much value on the software they use really shouldn't. Computers serve the people, not the other way around. So quit writing 24/7 and actually write code. You know, it's bad when a Disney Machia can see when it's time to use Windows. For those who put me in the background, it's a fat guy. Like, I can extend this to video games and movies or whatever. What difference makes it who wrote software but does share the ideology with you? Same with the video game. If the video game's fun, my character's made by a child model. Thanks for watching this video. I would appreciate it if you subscribe or follow or whatever you call the platforms I post it on. All of those are in the description. This was my first long video. I'm sure I'm uploading often, so I don't want to miss that. Next time it's going to be about game development probably. Any feedback about this video would be appreciated. Bye!